Hey BC, how's it going? Right, okay, Vinyl Tag 2020. I watched a few of these videos today from other VC members. Very cool, so I thought I'd do my own. So yeah, so first up, I'm gonna start off with the non-vinyl related stuff. So this is show, a book or a film, music related, that you'd recommend. So this is Krautrock Sampler by Julian Cope. If you're interested in Krautrock, this is undoubtedly the book to get hold of. However, it's long out of print and quite expensive now. I went to a book signing by Julian Cope about 10-12 years ago now, from one of his other books, The Megalithic European. And I said to him at the time, I've been desperately trying to get hold of this book without any joy. And he very kindly recommended some Krautrock albums, which he wrote down in the back of my copy of The Megalithic European. So that's quite a quirky little thing. But yeah, if you're interested in Krautrock, try and get hold of that. Lovely. Right, okay. So what I'm listening to the background is this. This is a CD. One of the questions is, show a novelty record. So this is a band called Senor Coconut. And this is their version of songs by Kraftwerk. So if you don't know this, I'd recommend it. It's loads of fun. Kraftwerk done in a Latin style, so cool. Right, okay. Right, so vinyl. So my best find from 2019 is this. This is Come by Prince, an album from 1994. A friend of mine bought a small collection last year, and this was included. He had it in his box to sell. So I got it for a good price, a really good price, and he made a few quid on it, so happy days, everyone's a winner, so good stuff. But been looking at it for years, and happy to find that. Right, favourite album of 2019, I've said before, is this. This is Doggerel by Fontaines DC. Spiky guitars, punk music delivered in a broad Dublin accent. I absolutely love it. Great songs, albeit that's getting quite a, shown a lot in the VC at the moment. So I also just want to mention this in passing as well. This is Surf's Up by the Fat White Family. Awful band name. I've hated all of the other music they've made. They made two albums before this, which were terrible, but I love this record. I read a review of it earlier in the year. Got a great review. I think it's in Mojo magazine, and I streamed it a few times, and I've listened to it so much. Probably the album that I've listened to most this year, so definitely recommend that. Check it out for yourself. Right, an album cover that's an homage. So I'm going to go with this. This is the Easy Stars All Stars with their reggae version of Sgt. Pepper's. So that's a take on the Beatles' Sgt. Pepper sleeve. Not as good as their other albums. Radio Dread, the OK Computer covers album, and Dub Side of the Moon are much better, but I do like that cover. Right, OK. A deep cut or an album track. So this is something I bought this week, actually. This is Martha Reeves, a self-titled album from 1974. Yeah, it's produced by Richard Perry, so it's quite a smooth sounding record. But I am going to do a needle drop on one track on this, which is her version of I've Got to Use My Imagination, which was a big hit for Gladys Knight and the Pips around this sort of time. But I really like her version, so I'll do a needle drop on that. Okay then, so two albums which are shelf buddies, so albums next to each other on a shelf. So first up, A Taste of Honey, their debut album. This is the one with Boogie Oogie Oogie on it, which is brilliant. And next to that is A Certain Ratio and Sextet, so lovely stuff. Right, okay, my favourite drummer. A lot of people have mentioned the likes of Keith Moon, John Bonham. I'm going to go with Roger Taylor out of Queen. So for me, Roger Taylor, undoubtedly the coolest member of the band. Those other drummers mentioned there, and others like them, have their own individual styles. But unfortunately ended up being the clown of the band. That's not the case for Roger Taylor. I say always the coolest member. He wrote great songs. I remember as a kid making mixtapes of the songs that he wrote for each of the albums. He even looked cool playing kettle drum solos on stage. And of course, he was pretty good looking when he was dressed up as a woman for the I Wanna Break Free video as well. So in a game of top trumps, I reckon that kettle drum enthusiast and looks good as a woman, I think pretty much wins it. So there you go. Right, okay, an album which I have a reissue of, but I like an OG, and I've said this before, this is Catch a Fire by the Wailers with the Zippo sleeve. This is a reissue from a couple of years ago, which I think the pressing is pretty average. I would love an original copy of that, but it goes for a couple hundred quid now, so outside of my price range. Right, okay. I was there, a gig that I went to which was memorable. So there's quite a famous gig. I live in Birmingham in the UK, and there's quite a famous gig happened in Birmingham on the 1st of August 1997. David Bowie played in Birmingham at a place called the Q Club, which, you know, it's not a big venue. It literally just holds hundreds of people. That's it, you know. It's not like an arena. It's just a small club, and he was promoting his Earthling album. I was at that gig, and it was a wonderful night. He mixed up stuff from those sort of mid-90s albums, Earthling and Outside, with some of his earlier stuff as well. He finished with a version of Look Back in Anger from Lodger, which is wonderful. He actually opened with Quicksand off Hunky Dory. He came out, stripped to the waist, with an acoustic guitar, and just would come out and sang that, and the place just went mental. It's quite a famous gig. I've got no idea why he played such a small venue for just that one night. But yeah, it was a wonderful night. So yeah, so probably one of my favourite gigs. So cool. Right, okay. An artist who I own pretty much all their stuff is Paul Weller. So all of the Jam, Style Council and solo stuff. There's only one of his albums that I've never owned, which is the second Jam album, The Modern World. Just purely because what I've heard of it, it's not very good. So I know that I do a lot of people's head in, not just having one album outstanding, but for see it cheap, I'll buy it perhaps one day, but I've never got out of my way to get a copy. So there you go. Right, okay, another Queen record, an album with an individual label. So it's a Night at the Opera, and the recording label on original copies looks like that, with the Queen crest. I know it's a pretty straightforward one. I know that Graham at Cracking Vinyl went for A Day at the Races, one after that, but yeah, that's one of my favourites. Okay, before they were famous, so an artist or a band before they made it big. So I'm going to go with Buckingham Nicks. I love this record. The three albums that Fleetwood Mac made in the 70s, the self-titled Fleetwood Mac album, Rumours and Tusker, three of my favourite records. But this is the album that Stevie Nicks and Lindsey Buckingham made before joining the band. So, yeah, wonderful stuff. Okay, a trilogy of albums. So, albums by artists which represent, you know, a high standard, but also sit nicely together. So, a recurring theme. So, these are the albums made by Isabel Campbell and Mark Lanegan in the 2000s. It's that sort of Lee Hazlewood, Nancy Sinatra duet type sound. So the first one is Ballad of Broken Seas. The second one is Sunday at Devil's Dirt. And the third one is Hawk. And I'd recommend all three. All three are lovely, lovely records. So cool. Right, something funky. Now this is perhaps the easiest one for me, but something to pull out at random. This is Freedom Express, Easy Riding. It's sort of funk rock, so I might do a needle drop on that as well. So cool. An album Same album, different cover. So the American version of the Afro Blues Quintet Plus One looks like that. Quite an average looking cover. The UK version on Pi is gorgeous. I mean, that's a brilliant cover. Quite a difference. And I'd go with this one every day of the week. But yeah, and a lovely album as well. So their debut. Right, an album which I bought cheap and is now worth a few quid. I've shown this before, I promise I'll never show it again. This is Wildflowers by Tom Petty. Brilliant record. I played a tenner for this about 10 years ago. It's worth a couple hundred quid now, I suppose. But one of my favourite records, so won't be selling that. Right, an album that's 20 years old. This came out in 2000. This is Primal Scream Exterminator. They made a trilogy of records, actually. This is the middle one of the trilogy, and probably my favourite album from that year, so wonderful stuff. If you haven't heard this, I'd recommend checking it out. I mean, just get online, I'm sure you can stream it, but it's one of the best albums of the 2000s. And finally, an artist which is consistent in his output. I would say in the 1980s, nobody was more consistent than Prince. I'm a little bit biased because obviously he's my favourite artist, but this is Sign of the Times. I'm pretty sure you've all heard this, but if you haven't, you know, what are you doing? Get out there and get a copy. It's absolutely stunning. So there you go. Cheers.